someone said, hey, I'm coming from another worship software and they call this one thing this. What is it called in ProPresenter? I've searched and I can't figure it out. So I thought that we would go through some of the common things that might be called other things in other software and go from there. Presented by Church Tech U, it's the ProPresenter Show. On today's show, ProPresenter Terminology. Hi, and welcome again to the ProPresenter Show. This is the show where I teach all about ProPresenter. My name is Paul Allen Clifford. And if you've ever been confused about, well, what's a presentation versus a playlist versus, this is the one for you. So this tutorial originated in the official ProPresenter users community that I run over on Facebook along with Renewed Vision. I started it and then they came along when we got to 10,000 members. Now we're, gosh, nearly 40,000, something like that. Anyway, someone said, hey, I'm coming from another worship software and they call this one thing this. What is it called in ProPresenter? I've searched and I can't figure it out. So I thought that we would go through some of the common things that might be called other things in other software and go from there. So let's head over to the computer and we will talk about that. So first off, this entire screen that we're looking at is the user interface, the control screen. I've heard it called a few things, but this is basically the screen that should always be up that you as the ProPresenter operator are using to control ProPresenter. So that's one thing that we have here. In the upper left-hand corner, we have libraries. These are places where presentations are stored. So think of these as filing cabinets, and you can have as many of those as you need. It's just for organization, so if one works for you, that's fine. I typically do four or five, but that's just me. Next we have playlists, and a playlist is just a list of everything that you're going to do in a particular day. So, and by day I mean like a single service. So if you're using this for church, you would, you know, start with announcement slides, typically maybe a countdown, then some singing, maybe some prayers, most definitely some prayer somewhere in there, maybe some announcements, maybe some liturgy, depending on your church, some responsive readings, a sermon, closing hymn, closing song, etc., closing announcements. So you'll see down here we have this list of things. Doesn't matter what's in the list, just know that if it is a list, it is a playlist. Now notice that this is not in alphabetical order. But if I click on a library, let's click on the library here. Yep, so this one is in alphabetical order. So A, J, S. So it's in alphabetical order here. So that's one quick way to, by glancing, tell if you have a library selected. You know, it could be that you've scrolled up and you don't see that. Or you click over here. Let's actually click on the playlist called playlist, and then you see all these things and they're not in alphabetical order. And also to the right here, it shows you what library that it is in. So those are a couple of different terms that are useful. The next important thing for you to know is what is a presentation. So if I click on this or this or this, a presentation is just a group of slides. Now, I recognize that those of you that are coming from PowerPoint or other presentation software might think that the presentation is the whole shebang. Nope. Think of it this way. So I used to do freelance AV work, and like a literal brain surgeon would hand me a thumb drive and say, hey, thanks for doing this. I don't understand this stuff at all. And I'd go, I don't understand brains at all. So that's okay. We're good at different stuff. So do you like these videos, but you'd really like to learn from me in person? Well, I've got some great news for you. I am traveling around the country and maybe even around the world training churches on how to use ProPresenter. So I've got either a 1 or 1.5 day class that you can attend. For more details, head on over to TDM.fyi/events24, the top one right here, and register for the event nearest you. If there is no event that's near you, no problem, you can request one. So head on over to TDM.fyi/class request. That's this one down here, and you can say, hey, I'm interested in attending a class, or even I'm interested in hosting a class. Up to you which you prefer. In the last one, that is just information. It's not obligation, so don't hesitate to put your information in there, and I'll let you know when there's a class in your area, or we'll talk about what it takes to host a class. It's probably a lot less than you imagine that it is. So head over there, and I look forward to meeting you in person. With that said, I would have to open his presentation, or her presentation, that are female brain surgeons, of course, after all, and have that one in a different instance of PowerPoint than what was currently projected on the screen. So when I went from one presentation to another presentation, I would basically switch over to another instance of PowerPoint. Well, ProPresenter is like, it is a piece of software that contains multiple presentations. So just think of a presentation as a group of slides. And so if we go back here, this is a presentation, and so is this. This is a presentation. This is a presentation that's a song. And over here, maybe I've got a presentation that's a sermon in a totally different playlist, etc. So it's important to know, especially because if you go up here to File, Export, you'll notice we've got Presentation and Presentation Bundle. Those will export just one group of slides. So, for example, this group of slides. So in this case, I would be exporting just these sermon slides. If I do just presentation, it just does the text. If I do presentation bundle, it includes the media along with the text. So that's why that's important. Notice that there is an export playlist, and that would export everything in the playlist that's currently selected. So multiple presentations. So an important thing to know. Next, if we go up here to Screens and Configure Screens, there are two other jobs that a screen can have in ProPresenter other than the user interface or control screen that we talked about earlier. One is the audience screen. This is the one that you probably think of when you think of presentation software of any sort, whether it's worship software or more business-centered presentation software, puts it up on the screen. That is where the slides live. These are, I heard someone call them the pretty slides. They have backgrounds. The fonts can be different. Maybe there are transitions. Maybe there are builds where things build in, etc. That can all happen from within ProPresenter, but this is the audience. This is for, in a church context, the in-person congregation. In a business meeting, it would be the people in the meeting, etc. Okay? This one, in PowerPoint parlance, would be called the presenter's view. But this is the stage screen, and the stage screen can do not only just kind of generic stuff like you see in PowerPoint, but you can even temporarily show what's up on the any one of the audience screens as well. So that's an important thing to know, is we've got the audience screen, which is for the people out watching the presentation, and we've got the stage screen for the people leading from the front, whether they're musicians or a pastor or some speaker or what have you. That's what the stage screen is for. It's for the people that are leading from the front. Sometimes it's called a fold back or a confidence monitor, and you can, within ProPresenter, you can change how that information is displayed. This is, again, someone I heard called it the ugly screen, because you're not putting up necessarily all the prettiness. You're just, it's very utilitarian. It shows the words and makes them as legible as possible, because that is what the person that's leading from the front needs more than for it to be pretty. It needs to be more legible. They're already engaged in the process of leading. They're not necessarily caring how pretty it looks. So that's that. Over here we have the preview screen, and underneath this is a little drop down so I can preview any of my audience screens or any of my stage screens as well. There are tons of other things that are within ProPresenter, but those are kind of some of the basics. One I did want to touch on is arrangements right here. This icon looks kind of like arrows going in opposite directions with three boxes in the middle, and that enables you to reorder stuff. You probably wouldn't do that with the sermon, but for, let's say, a song, you might have multiple arrangements of this particular song that you sometimes sing it verse 1, chorus, verse 2, chorus, verse 3, chorus, chorus. Sometimes you sing it verse 1, chorus, verse 3, chorus, chorus, and then you're done. You know, sometimes you just sing the chorus, etc. You don't have to have that separate versions of the song within the library. You can have just one with multiple arrangements. So if we click on this, you'll notice that I can add a new arrangement, and then I can use these little groups to rearrange things, and it will show automatically right here, showing exactly which of the arrangements that we have. So, tons of stuff within ProPresenter. I might come back and do more about the terminology, but I just wanted to go over some of the basics of terminology in ProPresenter. If you like this content, you'd probably like my ProPresenter 7 Quick Start course. So head on over to TDM.fyi/proquick. Give me your name and email address, and I'll make a login for you for free. Until next time, this is Paul Allen Clifford from TrinityDigitalMedia.com and ChurchTechU.com, reminding you to go out and change eternity.